On June 12, 1981, Clash of the Titans was released to theaters. It was the swan song feature in a long line of films that are unique in the history of cinema because they are a catalog of movies that are attributed to a man that could be simply credited as special effects technician, Ray Harryhausen. Based on Greek mythology, Clash of the Titans is a movie about the tale of the hero Perseus and his harrowing quest to win the hand of Princess Andromeda. Along the way, he captures the winged horse Pegasus, travels to the underworld, defeats the Gorgon Medusa, and the giant sea titan, the Kraken. Starring Sir Laurence Olivier, Burgess Meredith, Harry Hamlin, and Ursula Andress, with a score by multi-Emmy Award-winning composer Lawrence Rosenthal, and Ray Harryhausen's own brand of visual effects called Super Dynamation. I saw the commercials on TV back in the spring of 1981, and I thought it looked like a movie that I would love. Soon afterwards, my new friend Mike came over with his colored pencil drawing based on the movie. He had just seen it at the theater, and that drawing was the catalyst that turned me into a lifelong artist. And here, 42 years later, I have finally recreated that drawing.
Clash of the Titans.
Let me show you my Clash of the Titans collection. I've owned it on VHS, DVD, and Blu-ray. It's currently remastered in 2K, but it's not restored. The Ray Harryhausen Foundation is hoping to work with Warner Brothers to restore the film for a 4K release, using the audio commentary that Ray recorded 2 years after the Blu-ray came out and is yet to be used on any release. The tale of Perseus comes from Greek mythology from the writings made 3,000 years ago by Homer, Virgil, Hesiod, Apollodorus, Pindar, Euripides, Ovid, and more. I first read about them in this book back in 1982. This is the same version of the tale that Ray Harryhausen read as a youth, as written by Nathaniel Hawthorne in his 1851 publication, A Wonder Book for Boys and Girls. And here's the version of the story as told by Thomas Bulfinch in his 1855 publication, The Age of Fable or Stories of Gods and Heroes. And this is the Robert Graves more scholarly approach to the story. So there are some differences between the original tale from Greek mythology and the movie by Ray Harryhausen. In the Greek myths, Perseus flies with winged sandals through most of the story. Pegasus was spawned from the blood of Medusa, not the last of a herd of flying horses. Medusa is only one of three Gorgons, and they have wings and can fly. She didn't have an ugly face, a rattlesnake body, or a bow and arrows. Perseus also used the head of Medusa to petrify Atlas into a mountain. Pegasus was ridden by the hero Bellerophon, and Princess Andromeda was from Ethiopia. Also, the sea creature was named Cetus, not the Kraken. The Kraken comes from Norse mythology and is more of a giant Humboldt squid. The script for the film version was written by Alan Beverly Cross, first drafted in 1977, completed in 1978, filmed in 1979, and released in 1981 after 2 years of post-production work. Beverly Cross also wrote Ray Harryhausen's earlier film from Greek mythology, Jason and the Argonauts, back in 1963. Beverly Cross was the husband of Maggie Smith, who played Thetis, mother of Calibus in Clash of the Titans. Calibus, as well as the mechanical owl Bubo, are not characters from the original mythology. Thetis was, but she was the mother of Achilles, not Calibus. Interestingly, Calibus uses a bullwhip as a weapon, just like Indiana Jones, and his debut in Raiders of the Lost Ark came out the same day as Clash of the Titans. Also, the actor Jack Gwillem plays Poseidon in Clash of the Titans, and he played King Aedes in Jason and the Argonauts. The studio originally wanted Arnold Schwarzenegger to play Perseus before he starred as Conan the Barbarian, but that casting did not fit the vision Ray Harryhausen had for his film. This novelization was adapted by Alan Dean Foster from the film's screenplay. There's also this illustrated hardcover adaptation, and these two comic adaptations. All of these are based on the script, not the film, because they had to start working on them while the movie was still in production. So in all of them, you get differences like a pre-credit sequence of young Prince Calibus slaying the winged horses, and the deformed Calibus slitting the bag that held Medusa's severed head with a knife instead of stabbing it with the forked hand he would get in the film. They also had Perseus decapitating Medusa with his shield by throwing it like a frisbee, but actor Harry Hamlin refused to do this and demanded he cut off her head with his sword. The original script also had the Kraken tearing Pegasus apart. The hardcover book was illustrated by Mike Eagle, and as far as I can tell, he was born in the mid-1940s, is still alive here in 2023, and is nowhere near as famous as some rap guy named Open Mike Eagle. The comic adaptations were illustrated by Dan Spiegel, who was 60 years old when he drew Clash of the Titans, worked on many TV and film adaptations, and died at the age of 96. Dan's version of the Kraken appears to be based on this 15-foot-long prop that was barely used in the film, with its particular face never shown in the released version, but can be quickly glimpsed in a deleted scene that made its way into an early trailer for the film. The music used in the movie trailers was from Black Stallion by Carmine Coppola. John Barry of James Bond soundtrack fame submitted a 6-track demo cassette for a proposed movie score, which Ray Harryhausen passed on, though John Barry's name appears in the credits of one of the earliest promotional posters for the film. Ray instead approached John Williams to score the film, but he turned down the job and recommended Lawrence Rosenthal, who created a score that Ray loved and is still alive here in 2023 at 96 years old. A 2-CD complete score of the film was released in 2010 that is triple the length of the original vinyl album release. The movie opened in second place behind Raiders of the Lost Ark in America, but in first place in Europe. It would go on to be the 19th highest grossing film that year. It earned back triple its own budget and was the most expensive and successful film of Ray Harryhausen's career. There was a Clash of the Titans toy line from Mattel that didn't get a chance in the market due to exclusive contracts that had been made between Kenner and the stores for shelf space available for Star Wars toys, and so it was discontinued before all of the product could get released. There was also additional merchandise, such as a lunchbox, Halloween costume, a board game, and more. Ray Harryhausen and writer Beverly Cross worked for several years on a third Greek mythology film called Force of the Trojans that never happened. Ray retired after his 32-year film career and lived another 32 years, dying 1 month before his 92nd birthday. In 2007, there was a comic book sequel series from Tidal Wave Productions called Wrath of the Titans, and that was followed by 3 more trade paperback collections. A remake of the film was released in 2010, followed by a sequel movie in 2012 called Wrath of the Titans. In the last decade or so, lots of high-end merchandise has been released for Clash of the Titans, and I have owned and later sold my fair share. What I still have is my pre-release poster that I just got signed by Perseus himself, Harry Hamlin, a few days before his 72nd birthday. Here's a photo of the two of us, as well as the poster painter Dan Guzzi's autograph and the larger film poster. I also have this big poster book by Whitman Publishing. I don't know who the artist is, but it has 10 posters to paint or color at 14 by 20 inches in size. I've got 3 of the 4 puzzles that were made by Whitman. These are by artist R.L. Allen, and I need to get the 4th one if I can ever find it. Then I have these issues of Starlog and Starburst that have interesting contemporary articles about Clash of the Titans when it came out. I even have this replica of Bubo. And then there was that time that I added the Kraken into the Doodle Book. And last but not least, I have every book and film by Ray Harryhausen, as well as his autograph. Until next time.